So I brought this.
No, I didn't buy it.
Got given.
Present from your wife for your birthday.
Don't interrupt me. Welcome back, guys, to Robbie Robson's DIY Auto. Today we're on to the vinyl cutter. Now, this got given to me as a birthday present from my wife and gorgeous kids. This is hopefully going to help us with printing out stencils to do custom art on vehicles. And maybe later on, we'll do some design arts that we can stick on to the vehicles as well. But primarily, we're going to use it for cutting out stencils so that we can get some really fine detail onto the vehicles. What we have is a Yescom vinyl cutter T-Series. Now, when you purchase one of these, you don't exactly know what the make and model is, but the company that we brought them from, or my wife brought it from, was Yescom, and the model is a T-Series. But when you go to installing it onto your PC or laptop, it comes up with a whole bunch of other stuff. You don't even see Yescom, you see a whole bunch of other things. So this is sort of a product review of this plotter, vinyl cutter, and I'm going to show you what this machine can do. The software that it came with was a brand called SignMaster. It is a basic edition, that one there, very basic. When I look at the actual screen, which you probably see pop up on your screen right now, you can see that it looks old school. There's a whole bunch of very old type graphics on it. But as far as the program goes, it's very easy to use. So what we're going to do is just we're going to test it out, print out my logo, and actually before we do, I'll show you the products that I brought from the local Spotlight, because it's not easy to source these out in a short matter of short time. So we got next, probably its competitor, called Crewcut, and they have a whole bunch of different brands out there. So we're not reviewing this today, we're just actually just using this paper, which is transferable. So we're gonna actually make a couple of shirts. We might as well do something and put them on some white T-shirts. So this is just paper that has ink that you iron onto the shirt and then produce the logo and iron it on. So we'll go and turn on the plotter or vinyl cutter. Actually, before we do, plug it in, it'll be a good idea. And the on switch is on this side. Design wise, I think they could have done better. The cables could have been in on one section, but oh well, that's the job. All right, so what we do is go into SignMaster version 3.5, let it load onto the screen. We don't use any of these other images unless that tickles your fancy. So in my case, we're going to new document. We're going to set the page to 30.5 or 305 millimeters, because that's the size of the paper that we're using. And we like to keep in those margins. That'll give us that. So this is the main screen that we have here, and a whole bunch of different options, but all I will be using is our own logo, or my logo. So we go to File, Import, and then find my logo. I've cropped this image to fit better into this square so that it would save some hassles of printing out on the paper. So we'll center that as much as possible. Doesn't have to be perfect because this is going to be cut out. So what we've got here is my logo on the screen. However, like I made a mistake yesterday, I printed the image as is, and when I went to iron it onto the shirts, the image came out back to front. So we need to make sure that this image on our screen is back to front, so that when we go to iron it, it will be actually facing the correct way. So we right click on this, go to Objects, Display, Tools, Transformations, and Mirror Horizontally. So here we got a back to front image. So we need to tell the program where to cut. So it has a tool up here and a wizard called Contour Cut Wizard. Go and select that. These are the whole bunch of options which I'm still learning, so I'm only going to show you what I need to do to print this out. So we need to build that, so it'll come up with images word detected. Do you wish to include an auto trace contours? If we go yes, and we have a whole bunch of settings here, and I'll show you without changing any of these settings, I'll just show you what will happen if you just trace by itself. Now you can notice that it has put some blue lines in every single shape that we have. However, if you look at the A's here, there is no blue line in the middle there. So we need to tell the printer that we need to include those. So we need to reduce the minimum size until we see the blue in the A. There we go. So we'll zoom back out, and I think that is it. The R's, the O's, the B's have all got blue lines in there. So we can apply that, and we're going to accept it. And now we are going to cut. But before we do that, let's go and load. Actually, no, let's just go press cut and see where it actually is going to fit on our printer. And as you can see, it's not exactly, but I'm still okay with that. You can see that it's flashing here. So what it's basically telling you is those bleed position, cutter 1 inch below to the right, and reset the origin. So when we put the paper in there, we try and put it as close as we can to the edge of the paper, which I'll show you now. Now I could have got a more, I guess, masculine color, but I've got some pink, so I like to make one for my daughter. Daughters, plural. So let's just grab a nice dark one. So we've got that there, and behind it is a really thick plastic, which I noticed that when I was trying to use a X-Acto knife or Stanley knife, whatever you like to call them, it was very hard to cut that plastic, which is good. So let's go and load this into the printer. So we've got some levers at the back here. We push those down so it holds the paper in place. These rollers do move up and down to wherever the paper is. Hopefully later on I'll actually go and buy some big rolls that I can just have just sitting there so that it's ready to go. So just make that as straight as possible. On the screen itself, we've got a couple of settings. We've got speed and force, but what I've actually read online that it's best at to, if you want to keep nice things sharp and nice curves, it's best to keep the speed down and the force at 120 grams of pressure. Yeah, so that is in. So you can see closer what I have. As you can see, the paper is loaded in there. The screen tells you what speed and force or pressure. I'll show you the back. That's where the paper is loaded, and these are the levers I was telling you about. So, hit the cut now button. Proceed with cutting. is complete. So let's see if it picks it up a bit. Sort of see that's where it's been cut. So I'm going to put you down for a moment and I'm going to cut out, or sorry, remove all the things I don't want, and I'll see you in a few seconds.
15 minutes later.
All right, there it is on a white t-shirt, so you can see it a lot easier. That is with everything pulled out. Struggled with the A's because I think the smaller the hole, the more chance of it actually coming undone. But they're all on there, the O's, the R's, the B's, the A's, and obviously it's back to front. So again, we're going to swap that over and see what it looks like. All right, so I'll go and iron that. So we will turn that around, put some butcher paper on the back, and then we're going to put the iron over the top for at least 30 seconds on each section until it's printed on. So I will put you down again, guys, and I'll be back with the shirt hopefully completed. Fingers crossed. There you have it, guys. It's officially on a shirt. Could have been better, but you do with what you have. And I only had a basic iron. And yeah, but it's still that really, really good. I like it. But this may be something later on I might be doing, but for now, this is just a demonstration of what this cutter can do. And again, using vinyl to make stencils, to do custom art. But at this stage, my primary use is for stenciling. So there you have it, guys. I hope you like this episode. I hope you can see the vision that I have for my vehicles and to give it that little special touch. I wanted to obviously use this to create some sort of significant design on each car that I do, sort of like a signature, and this is the best way of doing it with the vinyl color instead of going freehand. So if you like this episode, guys, make sure you give me a thumbs up, share some comments if you like down below. If you think that I should do something in particular with this machine, definitely give me a comment below. If you haven't done so, make sure you check out my other videos. And if you're new to this channel, thank you for watching to the end, so definitely hit that subscribe button. And my name is Robbie Robster, and I'll catch you next time. Ciao for now. Peace.